team now. What do you mean now?
You got a phone number?
No, I don't have a phone number.
Maybe you ought to give it to Jim Cornette. He'll need all the... He'll have a lot of time on his hands after Monday night.
You want to interview Abdullah, Paul?
No, not really.
I didn't think so.
You know, Jim, I think you had the opportunity to interview Abdullah one time, and it wasn't a real pretty sight. I mean, he kind of likes to chew up all the things around, and...
I have the latest copy of Pro Wrestling Digest, and he devoured it.
I read that all the time. Hey, that Gary Hart, he's a good-looking thing, ain't he?
You're talking about this Gary Hart or the politician?
No, this one. He's the one. This guy that dated Donna Rice, isn't it?
No, I don't think so. Really? No, I don't think it was. I have no knowledge of that. Abdullah the Butcher. I mean, a vicious human being. There's that nerve hole we've talked about. The looks on Abdullah the Butcher's face, I think, tell a great deal of the story. His expression sometimes is almost blank.
Jim, there's never any wasted movement. Everything he does hurts somebody.
I like it a lot. Hey, come on, get a camera over here. Gary Hart's here talking to me.
Let him watch the Butcher. Let him
really?
Watch the
Butcher. You think so? But you make the ratings go up. You're so handsome, Gary.
No more handsome than you and the Butcher.
Oh, I like your tie. That's you. He's a gracious individual, isn't he? And he's here talking to me. You notice he didn't say anything to Jim Cornette this morning. He knows he's history, and he knows I'm here to stay. Magna, by the way, since Cornette's gone, maybe you could host the morning show, you know, because I don't want to do it anymore. I like to do it with David Crockett, but, you know, Jim, he thinks he's a college football announcer, and I don't want to work with him.
I don't think I'd count my eggs before the hatch, dog. A whole lot of things could happen, and a whole lot of things are happening right now in the ring with Abdullah the Butcher.
450 pounds plus. I tell you what, wrestling Abdullah the Butcher would be about as much fun as playing leapfrog with a unicorn. He's a bad man.
Hey, wait a minute. That's my line. You're stealing my lines now. Oh, I suppose you're going to get cue cards out here next, huh, Jim Ross, huh? Okay, fine. You want to steal? I can steal all your lines, too. Oh, it's a serious situation. How's that? Now I'm doing Jim Ross, huh?
Well, you may need to learn a vocation.
Oh, aren't we funny? Hey, go ahead, tell the people. If I lose Monday night, I can't even come back here as an announcer. Not as a referee, not as a tie salesman. I'm out. I'm out of wrestling for good. Tell them. I'm gone. I'm history. I'm ghost. I'm vapor. Tell them. I'm like an opponent for Abdullah the Butcher. No chance. Tell them.
Well, he's right.
Wouldn't that be a sad situation?
I'll tell you what, to bring it. As somebody said one time, what's he saying? That's the first time I've ever heard him speak.
He asked for dinner.
This nerve, old Ric Allen. Look at Allen's frothing his mouth.
He said, nice going, Paul. I know you're going to pin Cornette, and he'll be out for good.
Abdullah the Butcher, powerful slam on Ric Allen. This is one of the most evil men in the sport. Look at it. Look at the look on his face. It's just a faraway glaze. 450. The elbow drop right across the chest of Ric Allen, and the Butcher makes sure that the referee doesn't go down with a fatal three count.
The sadistic Butcher wants to make sure he gets him that last little bit of punishment because a man's already helpless.
The Butcher meditates, and then he will annihilate Abdullah the Butcher. 1, 2, 3, and the Butcher with another victory. And yet another long string of victories. Gary Hart. This is the kind of guy that Hart really gets along with.
Jim, when you look back on it, 450 pounds motivating across the ring, and yes, it even gets airborne, driving all the weight, coming down with the elbow, absolutely crushing his opponent.
Ladies and gentlemen,